Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Welcome to this live broadcast from St. Peter's Square of the recitation of the Angelus with His Holiness Pope Francis today on the 30th Sunday of Ordinary Time. From wherever you are joining us, I would like to welcome you to this live broadcast. Some of you may be joining us through various Vatican media channels, perhaps the Vatican Audio Live Events app or the Radio Vaticano app, the Radio of the Vatican News web portal or Vatican News English YouTube channel, as well as our Facebook live feed. To all of you joining us through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World Television Networks USA, EWTN TV, Shalom TV India, Salt and Light TV, Atmadarshan TV, Luminous Radio, and Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, as well as via other radio stations and other internet sites throughout the world, a very warm welcome to you all. My name is Ben Sinclair, and today I am joined and accompanied by Sister Bernadette. We'll be providing the English language commentary for today's Angelus. On Friday, the Holy Father visited the General House of the Salesian Sisters of Don Bosco as the congregation concludes their 24th General Chapter. He welcomed the newly elected Superior, Mother Chiara Cazzuola, wishing her well, and he asked the sisters to reawaken their vocational fruitfulness, heightening the challenges that they have to renew their yes to God in this difficult moment. Yesterday, the Holy Father addressed members of the institution Centesimus Annus as they concluded their 2021 International Convention on Solidarity, Cooperation and Responsibility, the Anecdotes to Fight Injustices, Inequalities and Exclusions. He urged them to find new models of development which are grounded in the Word of God, acting through solidarity, cooperation, and with a responsibility for their neighbour. And now we look and we welcome the Holy Father as he begins this Angelus address.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, il Vangelo della liturgia.
Dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of today's liturgy tells us of Jesus who, when leaving Jericho, restores the sight of Bartimaeus, a blind man begging by the side of the road. It is an important encounter, the last one before the Lord's entry into Jerusalem for the Passover. Bartimaeus had lost his sight, but not his voice. For when he heard that Jesus was about to pass by, he begins to cry out, "Son of David, Jesus, have mercy on me." He cries out. Annoyed by his shouting, the disciples and the crowd rebuke him to make him quiet. But he shouts even louder, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus hears and immediately stops. God always listens to the cry of the poor, and he is not disturbed by Bartimaeus' voice. Rather, he realizes it is full of faith, a faith that is not afraid to insist, to knock on the door of God's heart, despite not being understood and being reproached. And here lies the root of the miracle. Indeed, Jesus says to him, "Your faith has saved you." Bartimaeus' faith is evident from his prayer. It is not a timid and standard prayer. First and foremost, he calls the Lord Son of David, That is, he acknowledges Jesus as the Messiah, the King who would come into the world. Then he calls him by name, confidently, Jesus. He is not afraid of him, he does not stay at a distance. And thus, from the heart, he shouts out his entire drama to God, who is his friend, have mercy on me, always with a prayer, have mercy on me. He does not ask for some loose change as he does with passers-by. He asks for everything from the one who can do everything.
La gente chiede delle spiccioli. A Gesù che può fare tutto, chiede tutto.
It is, have mercy on me, on all that I am. Have mercy on me, have mercy on everything.
Non chiede una grazia.
He doesn't ask for a favor, but presents himself. He asks for his mercy on his person, on his life. It is not a small request, but it is so beautiful, because it is a cry for mercy. That is a cry of God's mercy and his tenderness. Bartimaeus does not use many words. He says what is essential and entrusts himself to God's love, which can make his life flourish again by doing what is humanly impossible. This is why he does not ask the Lord for alms, but makes everything be seen, his blindness and his suffering, which was far more than not being able to see. His blindness was the tip of the iceberg, but there must have been wounds, humiliations, broken dreams, mistakes, and remorse. And he prayed from the heart. When we ask for the grace of God, it's the prayer of our own history, our injuries, our humiliations, our broken dreams, our mistakes. Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. Let us ourselves make this prayer our own. Let us ask ourselves, what is my prayer? What is my prayer? It is a courageous prayer. What is my prayer like? Is it courageous? Does it take hold of the good insistence of Bartimaeus? Does it know how to take hold of the Lord as it passes? Or is it rather content with making a formal greeting every now and then what I remember? Furthermore, is my prayer substantial? Does it bear my heart before the Lord? Do I take my story and my life experience to him? Or is it anemic, superficial, made up of rituals, without feeling and without heart? When faith is alive, prayer is heartfelt. It does not beg for spare change. It is not reduced to momentary needs. We must ask everything of Jesus, who can do everything. Let us not forget that. He can do everything. He cannot wait to pour out his grace and joy into our hearts. But unfortunately, it is us who keep our distance. Perhaps through timidness or laziness or unbelief. All of us, when we pray, we do not think of these things. With the story, which we've seen, when there is a doctor with a child of 9 years old,
where? Se n'è andato 70 chilometri al santuario della Madonna.
And the doctor said there was nothing to be done, and the father went 70 miles to the shrine of Our Lady, and he grabbed hold of the gate. And the entire night he passed in prayer, asking the Lord to save the child and to give back his life, and also to the Madonna. But he spent the whole night crying out to God, crying out from his heart. And then in the morning, when he returned to the hospital, he found his wife crying, and she thought that he had died. And the wife said, they don't understand. The doctors say that something strange happened. It seems that he's healed. That cry of God that asked everything was heard by the Lord who gave him everything. This is not a story. I saw this in another diocese. But do we have this courage in our prayer to the one who can give us everything? Let's ask everything, like Bartimaeus, who's a great teacher of prayer in this respect.
May Bartimaeus, with his concrete, insistent, and courageous faith, be an example for us, and may Our Lady, the prayerful Virgin, teach us to turn to God with all our heart, confident and with faith that He listens attentively to every one of our prayers. And the Holy Father is now praying the Angelus with us together.
Benedicta tui mulieribus et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Ut igne officiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, qui angelo nunciante, Christi Fili tui, incarnatione coniovim, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine,
et lux perpetua lucet Deis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aeterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, I express my closeness to the thousands of migrants, refugees, and others who are in need of protection in Libya. I never forget you. I hear your cries and I pray for you. So many of these men and women and children they undergo senseless and inhumane violence. Once again, I ask the international community to maintain their promises to find concrete and long-term resolution to the constant influx of migrants in Libya and all of the Mediterranean. And when they suffer, especially those who are sent back to their countries, it should be ended sending back migrants to insecure countries. And they should be able to be given safe voyage and that courses that are regular, that are lawful, and that they be given. Let's pray for all of these brothers and sisters who for so long have been suffering this serious situation, and let's pray together for them in silence. We too now take a moment of silence to pray for all of our brothers and sisters who are trying to flee to a better life, but are faced with many, many dangers. Yesterday in Brescia, Sister Lucia of the Immaculate, a sister of the Handmaids of Charity, was beatified. She died in 1944 when she 54 when she was. Even when she never gave up, even when her body was just completely suffering. And today in Rimini, the young woman, Sandra Sabatina, who was studying medicine, who was killed 22 years ago in a roadway accident, will be beatified. Her daily life was filled with prayer and with enthusiasm in caring for the weakest, following the servant of God, Father Oreste Benzi. And so we give a round of applause to both of these new blesseds. Today, it's the on this World Day, we look at these two blesseds who announce the gospel with their lives, and with gratitude, I renew my greeting to many missionaries, priests, men and women religious, and lay faithful who, on the front lines, spend their energy in the service of the church, often paying a great price for their witness, and they do it not to proselytize, to gain converts, but to witness to the gospel in their lives, in the lands that do not know Jesus. Thank you to missionaries on this World Day of Missionaries. Even for them, let's give a round of applause. I also greet the seminarians from the Pontifical College Urbana. They're out there somewhere. They're hidden. There they are. And I greet all of you, dear people from Rome and pilgrims from various countries, and in particular, I greet the Peruvian community. There are many flags, Peruvian flags, who are celebrating the Feast of the Lord of Miracles. That's their national patron. Oh, the crash that will be set up in the Basilica will be from Peru. I also greet the Central Catechetical Community from Spain, the Daughters of the Sacred Heart, who are celebrating their general chapter, and the Emmanuel Community. I also greet the participants of the marathon from Treviso a Roma and those who are doing a pilgrimage from somewhere to Castel Sant'Angelo, the a Eucharistic pilgrimage in honor of Don Luigi Guanella, and I greet the faithful from he named three other places. And a special greeting to those who are participating in the week of social services who are gathered in Taranto. And to all of you, I wish enjoy your Sunday. We are having beautiful weather today. And please, please do not forget to pray for me. Enjoy your meal, and we'll see each other again.
And this ends the live broadcast of the recitation of the Noonday Angelus with Pope Francis here in St. Peter's Square on the 30th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Please visit the Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's Angelus, as well as other Vatican and world news. We'll be back live again on Wednesday, just after 9 a.m, when the Pope will lead the general audience from the Paul VI Audience Hall. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to thank all of the technicians who made this broadcast possible, and especially to all of you for joining us. A very happy Sunday to you all. Laudato Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ.